Very good morning, children. Today, in our EVA subject, we are going to start with a new chapter, that is lesson number 22, Patola. Now, when we listen to the word Patola, a different kind of image comes in our mind, and that is of block print design, and that too on sari or any dress material. Okay, so here we are going to study about one tradition, one art which is related to Patola, and this tradition belongs to Gujarat. Now let us start with the chapter. Children, please take the textbook along with you and listen to the content carefully. So let us start. Moksha and Nirmal live in a Salvivada of Patan. Now Salvivada is a place which is in Patan. So let us find out where is this place. So here you can see Patan. You can see Patan, here is the place, and in green color you can see the Rani Ki Vav and Sahasraling Lake. Okay, so here it is Patan, and here Patola heritage, you can see Patan Patola heritage, Patan Patola arts, and Patan Patola art. Here you can see so many place, and here you can see the BDS college BK Salvi, where it is the place, it is Salvi. Okay, so there is one Patola house where it is in situated in Patan in Gujarat. So their home is filled with bundle of bright color silk threads. Their mother Kokila Ban and father Ashok Bhai and everyone in the family are weavers. The weaving that they do is very beautiful and special. Okay, so this is the Patola making, and it is really very beautiful and special. From many centuries, Salvi family are living in Salvivada. The special weaving work done by them is known as Patola. Nowadays here, Patola house has established to inform Indian people and people from all over the world about their special weaving work. So this is the Patola house, you can see. Let us check out what are the things inside the house. You can see all the monuments, and here you can have a glimpse of how all the machine and techniques, whatever is used of make to make Patola, is been kept here in the Patola house. The craftsman who made Rani Ki Vav, or you can say Queen's Step in Patan, they also had used this design of Patola in their stone work. So let us see, this is the Rani Ki Vav, or you can say Queen's Step, and here you can see the pattern of Patola, here block print you can see on the design which is there in Patola, you can also see in the Rani Ki Vav. So these are the designs. Gujarat have also discussed about this craft in their folk songs like Chela ji mari har patan ki patola. Let us hear this song. Moksha and Nirmal's parents learned this art from their parents. Now Moksha and Nirmal also helped their parents after coming back from school and learning this art. So Moksha and Nirmal also are trying to learn this, the tradition, from their parents from the school. Now let us have a journey from thread to cloth, and let us see how this Patola is being made from raw material. So let us check it out. The thread which are used to weave Patola is made from mulberry silk. Now here you can see which is white. Father brings these silk threads from outside. The threads are opened and made into a grid. laid out in a crisscross manner. So here, this is the mulberry silk, and in this the crisscross manner how they are put like this. After the design is made on that, design thread is tied thereafter, which is called bandhani work. So here, and also it is dyed afterwards. Okay, color is been put on the material. So this is, you see that the part which has to be dyed is kept open, and according to the measurement it is dyed and tied up again. This work is hard and time consuming. When grid is designed and finished dyeing, after that it is put on the handloom for weaving. So here you can see it is put on handloom for weaving. This is the way how the patula is being weaved. Hence, after a hard work for 4 to 6 months, okay, here it is month, not a day, not hours, but 4 to 6 months, beautiful and colorful patula is prepared. The grid is fast colored, so there is no chance of washing out the color of patula. Durability and the color of patula remain the same for many years. That is why it is a saying in Gujarati that padi patole bhat fate pan fite nahi. So this is the saying from Gujarati that padi patole bhat fate pan fite nahi. As per this famous Gujarati saying, patola cloth may tear but the design and the color never fades. It aptly describes the true nature of the 11th century craft of patola, a double ikat woven sari usually made from silk in Gujarat's Patan town. So this is the 11th century craft, which is famously known as patola. Now it is a design, double ikat design. And here the patola words come from the Sanskrit word patikulla, which means a silk fabric. Though patola has a strong connection with Gujarat, the earliest mention can be found in South India. Okay, in your South India, as per religious text Narasimha Purana, okay, here it is known as Panchampalli. It mentions women wore it for holy ceremonies. So this is a beautiful art. You can see process of making patola of Patan. Now handicraft is in danger. In the preparation of patola, care and patience are required for the skill of weaving, designing and dyeing. It is a hard work of many days. Okay, you can see that first raw material, raw silk is brought, then it is tied, then it is dyeing is done, then it is put on the hand loom, and it takes 4 to 6 months to prepare one patola. Mulberry silk and colors are very costly. So patola are sold at very high cost. So maximum you cannot know what can be the cost of patola, but what I know is 1,50,000. What I know the cost of patola. Earlier there were 700 families connected with this handicraft, but now only 3 families are trying to keep this handicraft alive. So as it is a very costly, the mulberry silk and colors for preparing the patola. So in earlier years when there are so many people were attached with this profession, but now only 3 families are there who are continuing this tradition. Many people left this occupation. Patola handicraft is not only the pride of Patan, but it is the dignity and pride of Gujarat and India. So patola is really world famous. Patola is precious and unique identity of ancient heritage and Indian culture. It is going to be vanished. For that, we have to give good price of patola and help the kasbis. Kasbis here is related to the artisan, or we can say the people who are related to this occupation. We have to respect them and give them the good money so they are back again in this occupation. Otherwise, this previous art will be vanished. So if you not preserve, if you not take care of this profession, here this profession, or we can say this beautiful art will vanish. So let us check it out again. The patola are a double ikat woven sari, usually made from silk, and it is made in Patan, Gujarat. They are very expensive, once worn only by royalty and the aristocracy. Patola weaving is a closely guarded family tradition. There are three families in Patan that weave these highly prized double ikat saris. It takes 6 months to 1 year to make one sari. And here you can see the ikat is a method of resist dye technique. Okay, so that was zoom. This is an ikat, crisscross thing. And pochampalli and patola, it refers to the same technique of weaving, which is crossover between printing and weaving. The main difference between a pochampalli and patola, both using the ikat technique, is that the geography and the design language. Okay, here it is Gujarati design is there, in pochampalli South Indian design is there. So nothing is there, but the technique what they are using is ikat technique. Now here the question answer session, we will discuss in another session question answer.